What's up, y'all? This your girl Quamo. Today is Friday, January 26, 2018. I already posted an episode earlier today, but I kind of been pissed the fuck off, and I can't really get into detail and tell y'all why, but I'll just tell you this. It's because of these damn coons around here, boy. I can't stand a fucking coon. And I'm going to explain to y'all exactly what a coon is. A coon is a black person who tries to chuck and jive and entertain white people. Now, to all of my listeners out who are white, I'm not racist, okay? I'm not fucking racist. But I do have a fucking problem with white people who are racist towards me and who feel like they have a better privilege than me. So I call it how I fucking see it. And when these so-called black people be entertaining that uppity bullshit, then I calls them out about they shit. And I'm tired of it. So I'm going to talk to y'all directly about the history of fucking coons. I know that Black History Month is not here yet, damn it, but it's right around the corner. So today, y'all get two episodes for the price of one, okay? And the whole thing is, at least the price is free, okay? So this episode, you get on the house because I was delayed in posting my first episode. So I'm going to just talk to y'all today about what the hell a fucking coon is. So that way when you hear the term, you won't just be saying it. You'll know what it actually fucking means. So stay tuned and listen for this episode of How to Deal with a Difficult Fucking Coon. So a lot of people listening probably like, what the hell is a coon? What is a coon? I looked it up in the dictionary. All it says is that it's short for raccoon. Yes, it is short for raccoon. It is, goddamn it, it's short for raccoon. However, it is one of the most dehumanizing racial slurs you could say to a black person. But some people are still living in coon mentality. Some people are still living this coon mentality. The coon is supposed to be lazy. The coon is supposed to be it's perpetual or depicted like a child, and they're supposed to be childish, and they don't have common sense, and you know they do whatever to keep master happy and keep master entertained. And it's those type of black people that irritate me so goddamn bad, because we got enough struggles just growing up and having to be born in poverty and live in a community and then try to go out and get a job. And we got enough people of other cultures treating us bad, and it really pisses me off when people of your own culture will sell you out to white people. I can't fucking stand it. I'm not telling anybody. Don't take this episode and run with it like, oh, she hate white people. Never said that. Love white people. Love Mexicans. Love black people. I love people. I am a people fucking person. And if you are my friend, you know that I am a people person. I love people. However, I do know that there is a difference and there are some barriers between the black and the white culture. It's very apparent when you turn on the news and the television. You see it all over the place. You see it and you feel it. And if you grow up black, you experience it. I've been through hell. Been through hell when I had to be with just the all-white community and be the only black person there. And it's just been horrible. So, what pisses me off is when it's just you and maybe two or three other black person. And then, like, say y'all had a job or whatever you are. And then there's a white person in control. And you see they automatically shift their position towards you. They will sell you out in the drop of a hat and get to stuttering and get to sweating. I can't handle it. I cannot handle it, because you know what? That is one of the problems with our community. Stop trying to sell us out to other races, because as soon as you piss them off, guess what? You got to remember that you are still a nigga, and they're not going to look at you any better than they fucking look at me. They may tolerate you. They may deal with you. But when they're done with you, they're fucking done with you. Just remember that. The next time that you try to sell out your own people and get your people in trouble and try to turn on the other... No, I'm not with that shit. Like I said, I treat everybody fair, but I know what's real. I know what the hell is going on, okay? And it's a lot of injustices, and And it's a lot of unfair treatment, and it's a lot of poverty. And one of the reasons we can't climb out of poverty is because of black people who want to coon, so to speak, and turn their people in to higher superiors. I can't deal with that. If you one of these type of people, my friend, you are a motherfucking coon. And I will play a song. I'm going to play the whole entire song so that you guys can get the full definition of what the hell a coon is.
Nigga jokes while he in the room, he gon' laugh harder than you, cause he a coon. I'm a goon, top down, pants up when I walk. Never call a CEO or a boss, I'm not a coon. Boom, it's the elephant in the room. Nah, that's a motherfucking coon. Black's been free since Lincoln got wasted, but some of these niggas still on the plantation. Listen up, Charles Barkley. You light skinned, but they still calling you a darkie. The only reason that they put the mic in your face is so you can do that dirt and talk down on your race. TNT made you big, put you on a wig. Now you acting like you never had trouble with pigs. You kissed a man in the mouth, but real dudes, that's a no-no. When you go come out the closet, you fucking homo. Saw you on television dressing in drag. What kind of dumb nigga say slavery wasn't that bad? This is San Antonio women, that's the kettle and pot. With that busted up looking ass wife you got. If you're selling out your people, you're a cool. If you hate your own kind, you a coon. Bootlicker, shuck and jive, you a coon. You a coon, you a coon, you a coon. If you're selling out your people, you a coon. If you hate your own kind, you a coon. Sailboat, got smoke, you a coon. You a coon, you a coon, you a coon. How to make a coon if you wish for a black one? Put some change in his pocket and give him a platform. Put him on suspension if he crossed that line. But if he's shitting on his people, give him more airtime. Stephen A. Smith, what's up with that hairline? Big mouth louder than four alpines. Got a chip on your shoulder cause your ball game sucks. And you gotta work with players that your wife wanna fuck. I'm a savage running through the field of muck.
Alright y'all, said I was gonna play that whole song to its entirety, but I fucking lied. That song is 5 minutes and some long. But if you was interested in hearing that full song, that was Willie D. Coon. That's the name of the song. You pull up on YouTube, iTunes, Google, etc. Willie D used to be in the group Public Enemy. Public Enemy, you know, y'all remember them. Public Enemy number one. Y'all remember them. But yeah, that's Willie D. But yeah, he just kind of went into detail about the definition. So now what I'm going to do is get into the history of fucking cooning. That shit stemmed way back to slavery, man. And supporters claimed that slaves were like childlike and unequipped for freedom. They were pro-slavers. And they acknowledged that some slave masters were not cruel, but they argued that most of them were not, that they were kind-hearted capitalists, and they would rather be on the plantation than to be free. And they had names for those like good old darky. They had another name, which was porch monkey. They have a lot of little discriminative slurs that they will use for coons. And so that's why it bothers me so much today when you see people still trying to chuck and jive and do anything to get their own selves ahead, even if it means belittling their people. I'm not with that. You know, I understand that some people, well, I gotta take care of mine. You feel me? Yeah, I feel you, but don't think I ain't gonna call you out about it. I'm gonna call you out about that coon fuckery, okay? I don't entertain it. I don't deal with it. I try my hardest to, and I'm not perfect. I'm not saying I succeed every single time, but I try my hardest to represent my people in a way that they know that I love them. And even when I present myself to other cultures, I want to present myself in a way that still looks like I have love amongst myself, because I'm not hateful towards anybody. But I really, 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 really dislike coons and racist white people. I have a problem with that, because if you don't like me based on the color of my skin, then why should I even try to understand you? Why should I understand someone who doesn't like me based off of my appearance and my culture and my inheritance? I can't help that I was born black and African American. And so I saying this, I don't blame white people for being white. I don't look at you based on the color of your skin. However, if you think that you are in a higher class, or if you think that you can simply discriminate someone because of your privilege, because you have the white privilege, then yes, I'm going to call you out about it. And for my people who support these type of white people and don't call them out about their stuff, yes, I have a problem with you as well, because you know what? The problem doesn't get resolved. We just sweep over it. And that's one of the things that I'm tired of. So today, I'm going to give you ways to deal with a difficult coon. Rule number one, remind them that they are a coon, okay? When the moment that they start cooning, tell them, you know what you did was very coonish. I don't like what you did that was coonish. Now, what will happen? They may get upset. They may have a bad reaction with you. But guess what? Now you have informed them that they had coonish behavior, okay? That's the first step. The second step, still love them. Love them, but stay away from them like the plague. Stay away from them like the plague until they change their ways. Give them time to grow. Show them that you still love them because they are black, but give them time to get out of that coonish ways and behaviors and protect yourself from all of that fraudulent bullshit. Now, not all coons are the same. Some of them do not understand that they are cooning. They don't know what they're doing is wrong, which is why you need to approach it. Explain to them why it is wrong. Educate your people. Be tolerant with your people and educate them. Like, look, what you just did was foul. That was coonish. And you might have to explain how. You might have to just have some type of way. Be patient with those and try to educate them as much as you possibly can, because that's the problem. Ignorance is bliss. We are so ignorant to our history. We are so ignorant to the issues at hand. And a lot of us don't do research on anything at all. We don't read any books. We don't try to attain any information so that we can just avoid that behavior all the way together. So I encourage all of my black people and all of my white alias and my Latinas and people of all cultures, educate yourself about other people's cultures, histories, and the issues at hand, and we can eliminate a lot of the problems that we have right now here today. So I'm really, really concerned about the black people, though, because you know what? We the ones that's having a lot of these problems, and we really need to try to understand what is going on with us so that we can avoid it. A lot of this can be avoided. But to the coons out here who know, you have the knowledge and you know exactly what you are doing, shame on you. Shame on you, motherfucker. Shame on you. You know, I'm not going to deal with you. If you know, because some people, they don't have a lack of knowledge. They understand exactly what they are doing. They understand exactly that they are selling their people out. But because they want some profit or they want some type of recognition from master, they'll do it. They will do it every time. Every single time. So you got to guard yourself from those type of people, y'all. And again, you know, I know that I touched on two very, very touchy topics today. I talked about abortion earlier today, and now I'm talking about cooning. And it's two things that affect our community heavily, because we need more support within our community. The cooning is very, very upsetting to me, and this one I feel like I may be a little bit biased when I speak about this topic, because it bothers me so much to see my people selling each other out and not building each other up and putting each other on our back. We gotta be like Legos, y'all. We gotta stack, build, and be of all different little shades and just be beautiful. I don't know if Legos was a good example, but I use Legos, okay? Damn it, Legos. Let's stack, let's build, let's do this, you know, my people. Let's just stop with the cooning. Cooning pisses me off. I can't stand it. We have to have each other's back, because this is the only way it's going to work. And you know what that reminded me of? It reminded me of that movie, Birth of Our Nation, right? Have anybody, if you have not seen Birth of a Nation, please go see Birth of a Nation. It's the Nat Turner story of how he started a rebellion and how he got a lot of slaves together, and they basically did the damn thing. They was on a mission to get their freedom. Very good movie. I think they did a good job on the movie. It was Nat Parker who did the movie. So very good movie. You guys should watch it. Now, anyways, it reminded me he had got the rebellion all started, right? He getting ready to go to war. And as soon as he get ready to go to war, he can't find one of the soldiers, the little kid soldiers. He looks, the little boy then went and told Master the whole plan. And so they were destroyed. We got to stop that, okay? It's way in our history. It's time for us to not keep letting history repeat itself. That's one of the things we got to stop. Thing we got to do as black people, we got to stop living out today's stereotypes and being niggas. You know, we don't have to be lazy niggas. Everybody needs to be working. Everybody needs to be grinding. Everybody needs to get some money. You feel me? You men out there, we need y'all. We need y'all to get some money. We need y'all to protect us. And we need it just more in our communities. Stop living out to the stereotype that they set out for us. We don't have to do that. We can change that by just getting to some money. Saving up some money. Stop getting into all of these situations that can be avoided. And I understand, because when we up in the projects, it's easier said than done. That environment, sometimes you just got to do what you got to do. It's about survival. And I understand that. But the more that you educate yourself, do not live out to be another stereotype. You don't have to be a crackhead, or you don't have to be this dope fiend, or you don't have to be no thief. You don't have to be no thug. You don't have to be no criminal. And you don't have to just be these niggas that they set us out to be. Now, if you're going to be a criminal, be one for the right reasons. Because sometimes shit happens. You got to do what you got to do. You got to do what you got to do. I understand how it is growing up in these communities. But what I don't understand is people who want to sit around and not get no money. Get some money. Get some stuff established for yourself so we can start buying our own properties. Because that too is a form of cooning, because that's what they think we are, a bunch of fucking porch monkeys. That we just sit on the porch all day and do nothing. Now don't get it twisted, y'all. Not once did I say we need to try to get some acceptance. Because we don't have to do nothing to be accepted by nobody. The only person that we need acceptance from is the Most High. So, again, we need to stop trying to be accepted into all of these other communities and worry about our own, building our own up so that we won't be the minority, but we can be what we actually are, which is the majority. We max in population. So it's time to max in money. It's time to max in business. It's time to max in class, because that's what we originate from. We come from a land of kings and queens. So I am going to play a clip. Y'all know I'm the clip queen. I'm always playing clips because I just feel like it's always better to have something informative when you're trying to give education. It's better to have multiple messages that comes from different people delivering it, because sometimes it's not the message, but it might be the person who's delivering it, or it might be the delivery of the message. So I always try to include a clip that could support me or inspire y'all differently mental wise. So yeah, y'all just keep listening.
To understand this, you have to go back to what young brother here referred to as the house Negro and the field Negro. Back during slavery, there was two kinds of slaves. There was the house Negro and the field Negro. The house Negro, they lived in the house with master. They dressed pretty good. They ate good because they ate his food, what he left. They lived in the attic or the basement, but still they lived near their master. And they loved their master more than the master loved himself. They would give their life to save their master's house quicker than the master would. The house Negro, if the master said, "We got a good house here," the house Negro said, "Yeah, we got a good house here." Whenever the master said "we," he said "we." That's how you can tell a house Negro. If the master's house caught on fire, the house Negro would fight harder to put the blaze out than the master would. If the master got sick, the house Negro would say, "What's the matter, boss? We sick? We sick?" He identified himself with his master more than his master identified with himself. And if you came to the house Negro and said, Let's run away. Let's escape. Let's separate. That house Negro would look at you and say, man, you crazy. What you mean separate? Where is there a better house than this? Where can I wear better clothes than this? Where can I eat better food than this? That was that house Negro. In those days, he was called a house nigger. And that's what we call him today, because we still got some house niggers running around here. This modern house Negro loves his master. He wants to live near him. He'll pay three times as much as the house is worth just to live near his master. And then brag about, I'm the only Negro out here.
I'm the only one on my job. I'm the only one in this school. You nothing but a house Negro. And if someone come to you right now and say, let's separate, you say the same thing that the house Negro said on the plantation. What you mean, separate? From America? This good white man? Where you gonna get a better job than you get here? I mean, this is what you say. I ain't left nothing in Africa. That's what you say. Why, you left your mind in Africa.
Well, y'all, that was the great Malcolm X. Rest in peace, Malcolm X. You know, he said some powerful things that I feel like we all need to just take heed to. If we don't want to keep being oppressed, if we don't want to keep being in poverty, we got to find a way to break out of poverty. And the best way to break out of poverty is by sticking together and promoting those who are already on the road to success so that we too can become successful ourselves. So I'm going to conclude this episode, and near the end of this episode, I will be playing music from my Midwest artists. One is Lady T.Y., the other is A.C. Johnson, and the last one but not least, the Paperboy, a.k.a. Reese. So, thank y'all for listening and tuning in. Make sure you share, subscribe, and sub-listen. I mean, subscribe and share. Excuse me, y'all, my tongue gets hot. Share, subscribe, and listen, and share with anyone you come in contact with. I will be doing another episode tomorrow, and tomorrow's title will be Going to School and Financial Aid Issues. Talk to y'all tomorrow.